Turn to our top story this half an hour. New questions being raised about the timeline in the moments before the Las Vegas shooting rampage. The company that runs Mandalay Bay Resort disputes the revised Sheriff's Department account. A spokesperson says this: "We cannot be certain about the most recent timeline that has been communicated publicly, and we believe what is currently being expressed may not be accurate." This comes after Clark County Sheriff Joe Lombardo had said gunman Stephen Paddock shot a Mandalay Bay security guard 6 minutes before opening fire on a country music festival. That's different than the original report that the guard was hurt after the rampage. Joining me right now is former New York City Police Commissioner and K2 Intelligence Vice Chairman Ray Kelly. Ray, it's great to see you.
Good to be with you, Maria.
Thank you so much for joining us. What's your reaction to this conflicting report? Why would the hotel come out and say this may not be accurate? And what does that tell us about this investigation?
These timelines, by definition, are going to be fluid because people don't know exactly what happened. Here's a guard that's shot. We don't know what his reaction was. He didn't have a radio. So was he on the ground? He went, apparently, and found a phone. I think it's understandable that they're not precise, certainly at this time. There's still a lot of information to be gathered. I think, by the way, the sheriff, Sheriff Lombardo, has done a great job of putting information out.
He has.
Certainly in the day of the shooting, he was out every 2 hours, 3 hours, and that's what people want.
Even though we don't really have enough info here, is it odd to you that we still don't know a motive? I mean, this guy had 47 guns, and yet nothing in terms of motive and what he was thinking and whether or not there's more to it.
Yeah, I think it may just be an obscene, macabre effort to get his name in history. Almost as simple as that. This was not a dummy. He was a smart guy. He planned this for a while. He went to other locations, apparently went to Boston, went to Chicago, went to other locations in Las Vegas. He wanted to do this, got 13 guns in the last year. He wanted his name, in my judgment, to go down infamy, I guess.
So that's it. You just think it's just nothing more than that. There's nothing to read into it. Because I'm thinking, how did he become so savvy with all this stuff? Did he get radicalized? But they keep saying there's nothing, no ties to terrorism.
No, he didn't seem to have time. He was in a casino 14 hours a day gambling.
Yeah,
you know?
Yeah,
so,
that's true. Good point.
No, nothing ideological, apparently.
But here's a guy who goes to the 32nd floor of a hotel and just starts spraying the crowd and killing all of those people. Is there anything that can be done? I mean, what should the police department be doing to try to avoid this happening again?
It's just very, very difficult. You have these big casinos, big hotels, lots of people moving in and out. He was a regular at several of these hotels, so I don't think he would raise suspicion by bringing in several bags. And again, maybe he got certain courtesies because he was a regular. Maybe that's why they left the door, the do not disturb sign up. So, you know, it's very difficult to stop something like this.
Yeah, more will be revealed on that. Meanwhile, the bump stocks part of the story. YouTube is removing videos on how to make bump stocks, the device that's similar to what Paddock used to turn his semi-automatic weapon into a fully automatic weapon. There are no laws banning bump stocks. Should there be?
Yes, absolutely. And I think you'll see that. These things will be, you know, made illegal. Not that it's necessarily going to stop because you have them out there already in the public. But, you know, that's just a small part of it. Look at the damage that's done with semi-automatic rifles. Omar Martin last year in Orlando killed 49 people, wounded 58 other people. This is with a semi-automatic. So, yeah, these things should not exist. I'm surprised that, with such a hyper-technical definition and determination that these things were legal. Yeah. I mean, this mimics a machine gun. Machine guns are, you know, unlawful. Therefore, anything that mimics it should also be unlawful. The process, I'd like to see the process that go through. It just doesn't seem to be logical.
Right. Even the NRA, by the way, said, the bump stock needs more regulation.
Yeah.
I mean, even the NRA said
right.
it. Yeah. Meanwhile, several victims of the Las Vegas rampage have filed a suit against the Texas company that sells bump stocks, saying that the shooting would not have been as massive if the gunman had used a conventional gun. So they're suing this company that makes the bump stocks. Valid?
Yeah. Well, we'll see. But I think they initially marketed this as an aid to disabled people. Somehow this extra stock was going to be, you know, help disabled people. Whether or not that's a ruse, I don't know. But very quickly it went to being fired on ranges, apparently. And I never heard of it. Mm. And I talked to other police officers. They never heard of it.
Now, 2 years before this tragic event, Steve Wynn, the CEO of Wynn Resorts, said that he reached out to you and to other experts about creating his own in-house counterterrorism unit. Here's what he told Fox News Sunday, this past Sunday.
We had to recruit and expand security by tens of millions of dollars to cover every entrance, to retrain the entire workforce from housekeeping and room service, and people are in the tower.
It's sort of a sign of the times. Does every major venue in the country need an in-house counterterrorism unit?
Well, I'll tell you, Steve Wynn was ahead of the curve, no question about it. I did meet with him 2 years ago. He was totally focused on security. He did train all his employees. He brought in Navy SEALs and Marine Corps embassy security people.
Wow.
You know, he made a major commitment to it, and to that extent, he was ahead of the curve.
Because now, when you look at big venues where they have the capacity to fill thousands of, for thousands of people, you got to worry about this.
You know, we live in a dangerous world.
Right.
You know, you can't worry about everything. I think now you'll see security beefed up in a lot of these major venues.